minutes to go. LNG on the first stage, liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen on the second stage. New Glenn looking beautiful. And there you go.
Beachgoers with a great view.
What makes this place so special down here on the Space Coast? A day on the beach, but you can sit there because our pad is so far south. A spectacular view for everybody here in Cocoa Beach.
Now we've transitioned from ground power to the vehicle's own internal power. I mean, we are getting close. Ariel, hold my hand. I'm getting really excited. There are those BE-4s, seven of them, ready to take New Glenn.
3.85 million pounds of thrust combined.
T-minus 60 seconds.
In just 60 seconds here, as mentioned before, we will light four of the engines, then three of the engines, just about a second or two off for a staggered start. You'll see the big water deluge, and that's when you know that it's game on.
I love hearing all those sounds.
You hear the power up.
You certainly do.
And with that,
you'll see that water any second now.
Let's turn it over to launch control. Let's go, New Glenn.
GS1 hydraulics internal.
Never tell me the odds.
GS1 at flight level. GS2 at flight level. Autopilot enabled. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift up detector.
First motion.
New Glenn has cleared the tower.
New Glenn has cleared the tower! Go, baby, go!
Pushing 7-gear engines. 30 seconds into flight. Engine operating parameters continue with critical thrust. Body weight is conscious and nominal. 40 seconds in. End of list, brakes now level. 50 seconds
into flight, continue to take
good engine operating parameters.
A clean burn. We're coming up here on max Q, maximum dynamic pressure. This is the farthest point on the vehicle when it comes to the pressures and the speed. We want to see this rocket punch through. That max Q will stand by.
Good control, good MR control. 1 minute, 15 seconds in. Now passing Mach 1, New Glenn is now supersonic.
Supersonic!
And we can hear the roar.
1 minute 30 seconds. Engine operating parameters continue to look good at full thrust. Max Q, maximum dynamic pressure. One minute 45 seconds in. All seven V4 engines continue to look good. Body rate's nominal. Seeing good control on MR and TDC. Acceleration profile nominal. Now passing 2 minutes into flight.
The 7 BE-4 is unreal.
One minute remaining in boost phase.
All right, 1 minute remaining in boost flip phase. You heard our team say. Then we'll hit MECO, main engine cutoff. That's not going to lead to a sequence of events. We'll separate the first stage from the second. And that's when the first stage is going to begin its journey back home. We're going to see if we can land the booster separately. Of course, we will get the second stage off and going with the NASA Escapade satellites on board on their way to Mars.
Trajectory continues to look good, seeing good data quality coming down from the vehicle. Body rate response
great to hear
phenomenal.
That good data quality.
All seven engines continue
looking
look
nominal
good.
Next up MECO, which is main engine cutoff. The cheers are real. You can hear them all the way in here.
Miko.
And we have Miko.
And we have good stage set.
We have good stage separation.
Okay. And we have ignition on stage two. Both engine parameters look good.
Ignition. Oh, you see the two rockets there.
Body rate's camping out nicely. Both BPU engines look good at the high thrust checkpoint. Body rate responses look good. 3 minutes, 43 seconds in the flight.
Look at that view.
We have good indication of payload fairing jettison. Both BPU engines.
Great.
Continue to look good.
Fairing
body rate response is normal. Seeing good data coming down from both stages.
Great data. We're 4 minutes into NG2. And you saw the spectacular view
look good.
Down from our GS2.
Continue to look good. This is a 9.5 minute burn for GS2. 4 minutes, 25 seconds into flight.
All right, at 9 minutes is when we're expecting the first stage to touch down on Jacqueline.
Approximately 2 minutes remaining in the GS1 coast.
Thank you again, everybody, for joining us for NG2. So far, a nominal mission.
GS2 is now 320 kilometers downrange. Traveling at 2.8 kilometers per second. Trajectory continues to look good on both stages.
Clean separation, clean fairing.
Right down the middle of the range track. Engine operating parameters on GS2 look good.
Sounds like our GS2 is having a beautiful ride. The NASA Escapade satellites are exposed to space right now. And we've got GS1 coming down for landing at T plus 9 minutes.
One minute remaining in the GS1 coast. Continue to see good data coming down from both GS1 and GS2. Body rates on both stages look good. BE3U engines look good.
Everything looking good, looking nominal.
Seeing good TVC and MR
control on this moment
on
coming up is an important one.
Trajectory
it is. We're going
to look good.
We're going to relight the BE4 engines for the reentry
Body
burn.
Body rates nulling out on GS1. The exo turn is complete.
There you go. It's about 300,000 feet. Less than 100 kilometers up there, coming in for a landing on the Jacqueline, 375 miles offshore, waiting for the first time to land Blue Origin's new Glenn booster on the Jacqueline.
Continue to see body rates on GS1.
That looks great. We have our booster reentry burn.
Oh, all three engines. No matter what happens next, we have had a good day. This is further than we made it on NG1.
That's right.
See indication of engine ignition on GS1. Continue to see good data from GS1.
About a minute and a half.
Engine parameters look good.
Is when we would see
confirm engine cutoff.
Never tell me the odds. Return to Earth.
You see it in kind of horizontal position. We've got the strakes on the base of the booster, which give it lift. So
right.
We can basically fly this booster. Of course, we're using the forward fins as well, plus some of our reaction control system, as well as the gimbling on the BE4 engines to turn the rocket accordingly. On here, it starts to tilt down.
Now halfway
1 minute to go.
GS1 sits for GS2 systems. Continue to look good. GS2 throttle down complete. Responses look good. Minutes, 20 seconds from the flight. And we have landing burn ignition. And we have landing burn ignition from three good engines.
We've got our booster landing burn.
Engine control looks good.
Of course those clouds are there.
8 minutes, 43 seconds. Flight deployed.
Great shot from our booster.
Standing back to touch. Standing back to touchdown. Now 1,600 kilometers downrange, traveling at 5.9 kilometers per second.
On the right-hand side, GS2. On the left-hand side, you have our booster, our new
booster. Less than 2 minutes now remaining.
Never tell me the odds. Right there on the Jacqueline in the middle of that feather. Absolutely incredible. Congratulations, guys.
A landed orbital rocket. What an incredible
day
for Blue Origin, for the space industry.
These two systems continue to look good to return.
I'm speechless. Which is rare for me.
Approximately 1 minute remaining in the burn.
GS2 continues.
Of course, on a nominal path.
On a nominal path. I need a second to catch you.
GS2 body rates remain stable.
I think I heard my hand banging on the table too much. This is incredible.
TVC and MR. Tank pressures are nominal. Bottle pressures are stable.
Oh, I'm getting worried they're going to replay the landing. That's something so good, you got to watch it twice. Give it back to us.
12 minutes, 30 seconds in the flight.
Look at that.
Beautiful.
Standing by for Chico 1 shortly.
Landing.
Perfect.
Of the first stage of New Glenn with the one central BE-4. Let's wait here for our second stage. It's going to cut off its engine. It's done its first burn.
And we have SECO, GS2 engine cut off.
SECO 1.
Yeah.
SECO 1 is confirmed, GS2 right down the track.
Damping out nice.
Currently in the coast
space. We have one
One for two so far on our two objectives for our second mission of New Glenn. We have landed the booster for the first time ever. And next up, in about 20 minutes here, we are going to separate the blue and gold satellites of NASA's Escapade mission. Of course, one of the most important thing of any launch is making sure you get the payload where they need to go. And there's our team in camp. Hey, guys!
That's right! Oh, I see the celebration.
Turn it up.
Huntsville,
thank you. Thank you for those beautiful engines.
GS2 systems are operating nominally as the vehicle's in its first.
We love you too, Huntsville.